It has a navigation sensor, which looks quite interesting, compact. I was expecting a Geo Slam kind of size of a rotating sensor, but it seems to be like more like a camera-driven sensor and an obstacle sensor as well. Because these Geo Slam could actually create mapping. I noticed some of the navigation outcome on the mobile phone screenshot was showing this mapping of the area as well. So one of the biggest passion of running this tech channel is regards to robotics. I'm really into robotics. I want to have an automated house run by a robot butler and etc. Now, you would have noticed more than 2 years ago, I used to really dig into this project Vesta, which is actually a secret code for Amazon of trying to develop this smart home robot. And you can see one of the cringeworthy screenshot of what I thought the Amazon Project Vesta robot will be turning out, which is a reasonable approach, but obviously it looks more industrial look. But more than 3 days ago, finally, Amazon released a smart home robot called Astro. And actually, it was about 3 days ago, the video has been available. So let's actually check out and see what I can see from this clip. So here it goes. Right, so that's quite chunky, but home friendly. With a
Robot.
screen.
Yes. What are we going to do with a robot?
Many
Well,
things.
Astro, follow me.
Right, so there's a iPad-y kind of screen, very thin actually. Wheels, and it has some sort of like a holder on the back.
Hey, you got the toy I sent.
Yeah, I love it. Astro, follow me.
Oh, that's brilliant. So it could actually follow you around. And this is something I really like to do. I used to get conference call with my parents-in-law showing our newborn child. And oh, this is interesting. So
Yeah, turned it off.
And now I totally believe you.
Yeah, so you could actually, yeah, this technology has been known, but I'm quite
Message from
blown
Steve.
away with the camera popping out. That's very good.
Check.
Yeah, it's I get the feel it's not too big but not too small. And yeah, that's like Vector. You could actually it automatically charge. We know this technology all around. I like the fact that there's a big screen. I presume there's this webcam on the screen itself. Yeah, I can see that on the front of the screen. And okay, yeah, so home security monitoring and etc.
Let's dance.
Dancing. Okay. Yeah. What I'm really interested about is the backside, whether you could actually, what sort of things you could place on the back. But before that, okay, we hear the sound of some intruder, so home security. So the camera pops up.
Thought we weren't home, huh?
Okay.
Good try, though.
That's very good. I'm starting to really like this. Yeah, there you go. So you can actually send a beer can to someone else, which would be a really nice feature in your home, wouldn't
Thank you. All right, I'm
it?
in.
So she bought the idea. That's very good. Okay, that's very good. So Astro, meet Astro hashtag. So basically, this Astro robot will be only available exclusively by invitation. So you have to actually apply for this, and then if you're invited to this event, you can actually buy it only in 50 US states. So if you're based in UK or the rest of the world, like myself, you're not going to have those privileges. And also, I believe the actual initial price on the invitation event is going to be $999, and then suddenly after the invitation is going to go up to like 1,500 or $1,600, which is ridiculous actually, because I don't think many people are willing to pay that. Plus, we got this 6 months free trial of Ring Protect Pro subscription free. So in other words, you have to pay this ongoing subscription fee to be able to use the Ring Protect Pro as well, which is really put off. Now, so basically, it also will move around, avoiding objects, and also it could actually follow you around as well if you command Astro to do so, which is really good. But obviously, people will always talk about this issue, whether if someone hacks into your account, they could spy your home, which will be the opposite, really negative response to it. Now, the actual site itself is actually quite nice and neat, I guess because of the battery life, they have to come up with that size, and also the monitor as well, so they had to use all this sort of logics behind it. So that's, I'm quite happy with the size actually. And also the Ring camera that actually comes out as a pole, I thought that was a brilliant idea, because Astro has a certain height, what happens above Astro, because a lot of household like this is actually more than a meter, 900 millimeters height. How do you cover that area? So they actually cover that, right? But I actually thought, why not the actual Ring camera, or the tip of this whole pole could actually angle 90 degrees, so that it, when Astro moves forward and backwards, it actually could press the button. I just thought that would be a really good idea, because that could suddenly open up with different opportunities as well. You can turn an on and off button for the light switch, and also my speaker down there as well. Just a thought actually. I'm sure Amazon will look into that if they actually listen to my suggestion here. And also you could actually have a conference call with your family members under your permission, which is really good. And one of my favorite, which is that you could place your beer on a cup holder, or maybe you could have a cup of tea if it's if your mug is actually big enough, actually small enough to fit into the cup holder. Now, so it's basically a moving Alexa with a screen on, with a cup holder, I would say. But you could also put, well, that's a very good idea. You could actually put some fragrance dog, what is this? Like Furbo dog camera as well. Okay, that's really interesting. So it would be quite nice if it has an additional add-on accessory so that it could clean the house as well. I just thought about that, would be quite interesting. But anyway, this is the technical details, the autonomy of Astro, which is that a streaming indicator light is on the top, so you will know whether it's recording or not, working or not. There's this periscope actually attached to it, the Ring camera, and microphone, and the volume button as well, between the periscope and the monitor. So the monitor itself, this has a display camera. There was a sensor as well. There are three sort of round that you saw from the video clip early on. It has a navigation sensor, which looks quite interesting, compact. I was expecting a GeoSlam kind of size of a rotating sensor, but it seems to be like more like a camera driven sensor, and an obstacle sensor as well, because these GeoSlam could actually create mapping. I noticed some of the navigation outcome on the mobile phone screenshot was showing this mapping of the area as well. So it's a new navigation sensor, I think. Not that I'm an expert on it, but based on my study. It has a handle and the USB-C port on the back, which I guess you can use for programming. You could also plug it for charging your phone maybe. So that is quite interesting. It has a USB-C port on the back side of it. 2.1 speaker system, and you can see the volume of the size. It needs to be that certain size because of the battery as well. You need to fit in the battery, it needs to last long. A cup holder, power cord, and the charger, which actually charges itself, same as how the Dyson cleaner or the Vector robot that we have, and other Scout robot that I'm soon going to receive as well. So it's a quite interesting robot, but I just think it's the first model that out of the long going Project Vesta. I would actually look forward to see what will happen on the second and the third edition upgrade robot of Astro, to see whether it will become compact, because I think it's still chunky. The price wise is too expensive as well. So it will be quite interesting to see how the competitors will come up with a slimmer, smarter design. And I don't know which company is going to compete against them. Hopefully DDL, if you're listening, or many other Chinese firms who are very good at developing robots as well, with a hopefully much cheaper price. I have to say again, $999 is very, very expensive. Some people might consider it to be cheap, but it, when it actually goes above $1,000 of $1,500 or $1,600 after the invitation event, I wonder how many people are willing to buy this. Maybe certainly good numbers, but if you actually want to maximize the profit, etc. Obviously, I'm not an expert on that sort of marketing and etc. But I personally don't think I'm going to buy it because there's few certain things I do want more as addition. I don't know whether the USB on the back will be like for the function of maybe Amazon adding some accessories on it. That would be really cool, like a robotic arms that I talked about, you know, turning on and off and etc. But it's a very exciting time actually, and finally after this whole ongoing investigation on the Project Vesta, Amazon has finally produced a robot called Astro, which is very good to see, and I would like to see what other competitors will come up with smarter design and hopefully with much cheaper price. And I look forward to that, and I hope this will be the new era finally beginning with what all we've been waiting for, which is the smart home robot for all household. So anyhow, thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any questions or points or correction that you want to make from the state I made from this video, please do comment below, and I would love to dialogue with you lovely people. So all the best, have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.